So a lot to unpack here, very dramatic events. Garret Martin teaches at American University in their School of International Services. Research focuses on the European Union and the UK. This is a whole nother chapter, a whole nother book. Pretty remarkable day. Unpack it for us. Theresa May saying she'll step down, but as our reporter pointed out, she's probably still 20 to 40 votes away, isn't she?
Yes, absolutely, Mike. Another day of drama and intrigue in Brexit land. And it's become sort of customary to say that. So I think there's several interesting developments. First, the fact that the members of parliament had tried to regain control of parliamentary procedures. So I think that in itself was really fascinating. Secondly, I think ultimately you feel that Theresa May is using one of her last major cards, basically the promise that if they vote her deal, if they finally support her deal, which they've rejected overwhelmingly twice, she will step aside, hoping that that could convince some people to support her. However, it's still a substantial number. I mean, she lost by 149 votes, and she was not helped by the fact that the DUP, the sort of Northern Irish Unionist Party, mm-hmm. has still come out to say that they will not support the deal. So it's not clear whether she still has the votes.
So it's a gambit that may not pay off. These indicative votes were held. This is a tweet from the Financial Times correspondent. House of Commons once again votes for absolutely nothing on Brexit, and he breaks it all down. This is sort of embarrassing, isn't it, for Parliament and for all of those who said Brexit is going to be this fantastic deal. We're going to have our own kind of adventure. Won't be part of the European Union. All of these things, it was sold as one thing, it's ended up being something entirely different.
Well, absolutely. I mean, I think the problem is when you had a referendum that was essentially a binary choice between being in the European Union and not, but then when it comes to the nitty-gritty and the actual negotiations, there were whole kinds of options that were available on the table. And now the problem is finding an actual working majority for anything. So I think in many respects, I do agree that it has been a calamity. And I'm putting myself in the position of a citizen of the United Kingdom. It's not a very inspiring spectacle by the political class who nearly 3 years on have just been unable to come to any kind of meaningful agreement. So
if the parliament can't do it, should it go back to the people? I mean, should there be another referendum?
You could imagine so, but I think politically that would be incredibly difficult because you would be saying to the millions who voted, although it was a close vote in June 2016, you would be telling them, well, actually, on second thought, we are going to ignore your vote. So I think that would be really politically suicide for, I think, the major parties if they did so.
What's going to happen then?
Well, that is a very difficult question. I think there is a chance, I mean, it's not a guarantee that Theresa May will try to come up with a third chance for a meaningful vote on Friday. I still think it's going to be voted down. So, it's very hard to come up with any meaningful predictions. We have been surprised so many times.
So I think we're all focused on Brexit now, but there's another story that's already percolating, which is who goes to number 10 Downing. Already some people jockeying for position, right? I mean, that's another political story that's unfolding as we speak, right?
Absolutely. The knives are already out, and they have been out for a while. So if the deal does pass, Theresa May would step away in May, and then we would have a leadership contest. Certainly, there are a few names that we know, but I think probably the forerunner in terms of interest would be Boris Johnson. But Boris Johnson is a somewhat polarizing figure, but he does have sort of notoriety. So he certainly would be the favorite. But, you know, when it comes to these leadership contests, they're inherently unpredictable. So it might be someone that we don't expect who might rise to the throne.
Well, a lot to watch. Thank you for analyzing, of course. And it's a story that continues, no doubt about it.
Thank you, Mike.